Good morning everyone, this is Ganesh Chandra Bhatta, faculty IHM Kolkata. In this session, we will discuss the capital structure part 2. The scope is the factors, learning objectives. By the end of this session, the learner will be able to understand how the various factors influence the capital structure decision of a company. The various factors that influence the capital structure decision of a company are: number 1, trading on equity; 2, retaining control; 3, size of the company; 4, nature of business; 5, purpose of financing; 6, period of financing; 7, requirement of investors; 8, market conditions; 9, regular earnings; 10, flotation costs; 11, business and financial risk; 12, cost of capital; and 13, tax rate. Let's discuss in detail about these factors. First one is trading on equity. If a company raises more debt, the earnings of the equity shareholders increases, because the cost of debt is lower due to tax advantage. A fixed rate of interest is always paid on the debt funds, which is treated as an expense. The excess of earnings over the cost of debt goes to the equity shareholders in the form of higher dividends. Therefore, use of more debt in the capital structure in order to increase the earnings of the equity shareholder is known as trading on equity. Hence, the finance manager should always aim at having more debt in the capital structure of the company in order to increase the earnings of the equity shareholders. Let's discuss how the equity shareholders' earnings increase due to use of more debt in the capital structure. Let's take an example. Suppose a company issues 1000 equity shares of rupees 10 each and 5000 10% debentures of 10 each. It earns 30,000 rupees as operating profit, which is 50% on the total investment of rupees 60,000. Calculate the return on equity. First of all, to solve this particular example or question, we have to take the operating profit first. Operating profit means the EBIT, earning before interest and taxes. That is given 30,000, and from this profit we have to deduct first the interest on debentures, because interest on debentures issued by the company is a fixed expense which is to be deducted first from the operating profit earned. That is 10% of 50,000 rupees. This 10% of 50,000 rupees comes to 5,000, and when this 5,000 deducted from the operating profit of rupees 30,000, the resultant figure is coming 25,000, and this 25,000 is the profit available to the equity shareholders. Because after the operating profit, when we deduct the interest on debentures, then the rest profit is available to the equity shareholders, which is rupees 25,000. Now, equity share capital that we have already calculated, 1000 equity shares of rupees 10 is total 10,000. Now the return on equity will be 25,000, the profit available to equity shareholders, divided by the total equity share capital, that is 10,000 into 100, which is coming 250%. Now, from the above example, it is clear that with 50% company's return on investment, the equity shareholders will enjoy 250% return on their capital. Why? This is due to the lower interest rate, which is 10% only. In other words, after paying 10% interest on debentures, the balance 40% of the operating profit is transferred to the equity shareholders, which is coming rupees 40,000. This is called trading on equity. Second point, retaining control. The management control over the company is one of the important factors of capital structure decisions. The equity shareholders are considered as the real owners of the company. Therefore, they enjoy full control over the company. They take all important decisions for managing the company through the elected body of representatives called Board of Directors. The debenture holders have nothing to say in the management of the company, so the total control of the company lies in the hands of equity shareholders. If the existing shareholders do not want to dilute their control over the company, they must employ more debt capital in the capital structure of the company. In this way, by using more and more debt in the capital structure, the equity shareholders' earnings can be increased. Point number three, size of the company. Small companies and companies with low credit ratings must rely on equity capital because it is not possible for them to attract debt capital from the market because of the low credit ratings. But large companies with good credit ratings can raise debt capital easily. Point number four, nature of business. A public utility company which deals in electricity, natural gas, telephone, power, water, transport, etc., that has a unique support and identity from the state and central government, like Food Corporation of India, Indian Oil Corporation, National Thermal Power Corporation, Air India, etc., can raise its necessary funds through debt. A capital intensive industry engaged in manufacturing of iron and steel products may employ high equity in its capital structure. A trading company having less asset structure has to depend mainly on equity or preference capital to meet their capital requirements. In this way, the nature of business affects the capital structure decision of a company. Point number five, purpose of financing. Purpose of financing also affects the capital structure decision of a company. The long-term projects should be financed through equity. The short-term projects should be financed through debt instruments, that is, by raising term loans from banks and other financial institutions. If the financing is done for productive purposes, the company may use debt capital. Otherwise, it is better to rely more on equity capital. Point number six, period of financing. Period of financing also affects the capital structure decision of a company. If the financing is required for a very long period of time, the company should raise equity capital as it is a permanent source of capital. On the other hand, if the financing is required for a short period of time, the company should raise debt. Point number seven, requirement of investors. Different investors measure risk differently or simply charge different rates on the capital they invest. The company requiring large amount of capital must issue different kinds of securities to suit the requirements of different investors, such as equity shares, preference shares, debentures, bonds, etc. Point number eight, market conditions. Market conditions also affect the capital structure decision of a company. There are two main conditions of market, that is the extreme conditions, first boom and the second one is depression. These conditions affect the capital structure, especially when the company is planning to raise additional capital. Depending upon the market conditions, the investors may be more careful in their dealings. When there is boom in the capital market, it is very easy to issue equity capital because business flourishes during this period. And investors also take risk and prefer to invest in equity shares to earn more and more in the form of dividend. On the contrary, during depression, business slows down and investors hesitate to take the risk. So, at this time, it is advisable to issue debt capital as it is less risky and ensures regular payment of interest and fixed repayment of capital. Point number 9, regular earnings or cash flows. Companies with large and stable earnings may employ more and more debt in its capital structure because they become able to make regular interest payments and repayment of capital on maturity. Companies with small and unstable earnings are not at all advisable to go for the debt capital. They should go for the equity only. 10. Flotation cost. What is flotation cost? Flotation costs are those costs which are incurred at the time of raising funds externally through shares and debentures. That means these are the costs which are incurred when we go for the external sources of funds for the business. These include the cost of advertisement, statutory fees, stationery expenses, brokerage, underwriting commission, etc. Generally, the flotation costs for issuing shares is more than that of the debentures and bonds. That means equity has a high flotation cost than the debt. Therefore, this factor attracts the company towards debt capital. 11. Business and financial risk. Business risk refers to the risk of inability to discharge permanent operating costs such as rent of building, payment of salary, insurance, repairs, etc. On the other hand, financial risk refers to the risk of inability to pay fixed financial payments such as payment of interest, preference dividend, return on debt capital, etc. as promised by the company. The total risk of the business depends upon both these types of risk. If the business risk is less, the financial risk can be faced by utilizing more debt capital in the capital structure. On the contrary, if the business risk is high, the financial risk by use of debt capital should be avoided. Number 12, cost of capital. Generally, the cost of equity is higher than the cost of debt, since the debt holders are assured of fixed rate of return and repayment of the principal amount after a fixed maturity period. If a firm can arrange borrowed funds at lower rate of interest, then it will prefer more and more debt capital as compared to the equity. 13. Tax rate. The rate of income tax affects the cost of debt. If the rate of tax is high, the cost of debt decreases. The reason is that the deduction of interest on the debt capital from profits is treated as an expense, which is a saving in taxes. Sum of the lesson, the key points are, while taking the capital structure decision, the finance manager of a company must consider all the factors such as trading on equity, retaining control, size of the company, nature of business, purpose of financing, period of financing, requirement of investors, market conditions, regular earnings, flotation costs, business and financial risk, etc., in order to establish an optimal capital structure for the company. Now, you have the exercise to do. There are two questions given. Question number one, discuss the various factors that influence the capital structure decision of a business enterprise. When you are going to answer this question, you will have to explain all the factors that we have already discussed in this session. Question number two, explain trading on equity with a suitable example. You have to explain trading on equity first, then you will have to give the example that we have already discussed. Apart from this session, I would like to suggest some reference books for you. These are the four reference books which you should follow along with this session. Hope you have enjoyed the session today. We will meet again in the next session with a new topic of financial management. Thank you.